Hello, my name is Charles Gould and I'm with Michigan State University Extension. In this video, we're going to discuss scientifically valid and controlled composting methods that are allowable under the Food Safety Modernization Act Produce Safety Rule. When it comes to composting, microorganisms are our friends, but we know that some microorganisms like E. coli and Salmonella can be dangerous if they get into our food supply. Therefore, the goal of this video is to demonstrate how to safely compost and how to avoid cross-contamination when handling and storing biological soil amendments of animal origin. What the Produce Safety Rule means when it states scientifically valid composting methods is that researchers have performed repeated testing on standardized, science-based composting practices, and the results of that testing have consistently shown a reduction of harmful microorganisms. This means that when a farm follows the methods as specified, the finished compost will be considered treated. In other words, the harmful microbes will be adequately killed off. Let's go over the basic details of safe composting. A safe and effective compost pile begins with appropriately siting the pile. Ideally, the compost pile should be a minimum of 50 feet from wells, streams, and other water sources. The floor of the compost pile should be greater than 2 feet above the water table, and the pile should be located in an area that is well drained away from floodplains. Since manures carry and spread human pathogens, it is important to make sure it doesn't contaminate any water sources, therefore presenting a food safety risk to the farm or the surrounding area. Additionally, the manure storage and treatment site should be situated as far as practical from fresh produce production and handling areas. Consider barriers or physical containment to avoid runoff, leaching, animal, foot, or equipment traffic, or wind spread of that matter. Second, there are three key management parameters during the four stages of composting. Each stage of composting has a unique time and temperature indicator and microbial activity level. Stage 1 occurs approximately the first to second day after the compost pile is constructed. The temperature of the pile starts at ambient air temperature, but begins to increase as microbial activity increases. At this stage, the microorganisms in the pile are beginning to break down the organic matter. Stage 2 is from the third to the fifth day. The pile temperature should be between 100 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Microbial counts are very high, and so is the organic matter decomposition rate.
A lot of steam coming off. This would suggest that we've got a lot of good biological activity going on here. We're at 130 degrees. In fact, we've got plenty of moisture here. In fact, let's do the moisture test. Let me grab a handful of this material. And what I'm going to do is squeeze it in my hand. And I'm going to look to see if there's any moisture that comes out. I open it up. The compost stays together in a form. I have a kind of a sheen of moisture on my hands. This is the right moisture level for what we want to, the right moisture level for good compost production. So this compost pile, this 4 day old compost pile, is at 136, something along those lines, which is sufficient for pathogen kill. That's exactly what we're looking for.
At this stage, oxygen and moisture levels are typically depleted, and so the pile needs to be turned. Stage 3 is day 6 and beyond. The temperature of the pile is somewhere between 110 to 160 degrees Fahrenheit. Organic matter is breaking down fast, and the volume of the pile decreases by 50 to 60%. It is very common to see steam coming out from the pile at this point. When temperatures reach 160 degrees Fahrenheit in the compost pile, it causes microbial activity to cease. Stage 4 is also commonly known as the curing stage, and it can last for up to a year. The compost temperature drops back to ambient temperature during this stage. If we were to test the compost at the end of the curing stage, we will find that the harmful bacteria such as E. coli and Salmonella is at a very low level, which means very low produce safety risk. A static compost pile is not just a stacked pile of organic matter. Key to making compost is airflow. Ensuring this airflow in a static pile requires a bit of thought. Static piles have some ways to ensure the air is delivered to the center of the pile. Two common ways this can be achieved is by using large PVC pipes with holes drilled in them, or by using layers of straw that allow air to flow through the layers. In any case, static compost requires air to be distributed in some way to the center of the pile. For those using the turned or aerated composting method, the third management parameter to be aware of is the turning of the pile. Turning the pile incorporates oxygen, which allows aerobic microorganisms to flourish and keeps a uniform temperature throughout the pile. Most importantly, it generates high enough temperatures to kill pathogens and weed seeds. When compost is ready for use, it smells earthy and looks like a soil.
Nice color.
Nice earthy smell. Very nice. And that's the way compost is supposed to, you know, the end product is supposed to have that nice earthy smell to it. It has a very, very nice smell to it. When you put it in your hand, it should crumble easily and will not have any identifiable items such as wood shavings or leaves.
And if I take a handful of it, you know, it retains its shape, it's holding water. That's exactly what you want with compost. This is completely finished. So if I put my probe in, there should be no temperature reading. If it heats up, then something's wrong.
The FSMA Produce Safety Rule outlines two separate time and temperature regimes to make acceptable compost. The first regime is a static pile that must reach at least 131 degrees Fahrenheit for 3 consecutive days. The second regime is an active or turned compost pile that reaches at least 131 degrees Fahrenheit for 15 non-consecutive days. The produce safety rule requires at least 5 turns during the period where the temperature and time requirements are being met. Time and temperature records are essential in proving that your compost was made properly and met the scientifically validated methods suggested by the produce safety rule. Remember, if it wasn't recorded, it never happened. Biological soil amendments created, treated, and recorded according to the FSMA Produce Safety Rule may take a bit more time and effort, but the result is that you can be assured in the knowledge that the amendment being applied is low risk.